Good morning, my visiting guests. April is Alcohol Awareness Month. And alcoholism is the most severe form of alcohol abuse and involves the inability to manage drinking habits. There are three categories, mild, moderate, and severe. Each category has various symptoms and can cause harmful side effects. If left untreated, any type of alcohol abuse can spiral out of control. Individuals struggling with alcoholism often feel as though they cannot function normally without alcohol. This can lead to a wide range of issues and impact professional roles, personal matters, relationships, and overall health. Over time, the serious side effects of consistent alcohol abuse can worsen and produce damaging complications. Sometimes the warning signs of alcohol abuse are very noticeable, and other times they can take longer to surface. When alcohol addiction is discovered in its early stages, the chance for a successful recovery increases significantly. Common signs of alcoholism include being unable to control alcohol consumption, craving alcohol when you're not drinking, being alcohol about personal responsibilities, feeling the need to keep drinking more, and spending a substantial amount of money on alcohol, and behaving differently after drinking. An estimated 88,000 people die each year from alcohol-related causes. It's the fourth leading preventable cause of death in America. Well, why do people drink? Well, people can turn to alcohol for one reason and gradually develop a dependency on drinking. For example, drinking during difficult times, a death in a family or child loss, can potentially trigger long-term alcohol abuse. While there are various reasons why people start drinking, some of the most common ones are to relieve stress. Relying on alcohol to reduce daily life stresses can impact the likelihood of developing alcoholism. Since alcohol is a depressant and a sedative, drinking produces feelings of pleasure. However, frequent drinking builds tolerance requiring to consume more alcohol in order to achieve the same effects. To feel good, consuming alcohol can provide some people a break from reality. It offers a sense of relief from underlying issues of your mind, maybe trying to escape from. However, continued alcohol use during the day or week can turn into serious drinking problems. And coping with loss, like you said, losing a family member, our friend can take a toll emotionally, physically, and mentally, and to overcome anxiety. Some people are naturally anxious, causing them to perpetually worry. Drinking lowers an individual's inhibitions and makes them more comfortable in social situations. Over time, though, this can lead to addictive behaviors. The health complications from alcohol abuse, drinking too much on a single occasion or long term, can take a serious toll on your health. Some effects of alcohol may have a moderate effect on your health, while others may be severe or life-threatening. Short-term effects of alcohol abuse can be just as dangerous as long-term effects. For instance, drinking while can impact your reaction time, causing you to have slow reflexes and coordination. That's why drinking and driving is extremely dangerous. Getting behind the wheel of a car can alter your perception of speed and distance, putting yourself and others at risk. Additionally, consuming too much alcohol can affect your long-term health. Some side effects may lay dormant for years before they surface. Because of this, professional medical care is required for proper diagnosis and treatment. Some of the long-term health conditions caused by alcohol is brain defects, liver disease, diabetes complications, heart problems, a high risk of cancer, vision damage, and bone loss. In 2013, 45.8% of liver disease deaths among Americans ages 12, and I just said 12, and older involve alcohol. The first step of treatment for alcohol is to acknowledge that there is an alcohol dependency. The second step is to get help. There are different forms of treatment available based on frequency and severity of alcohol abuse. Although every individual will have their own recovery plan that's tailored to their specific needs, treatment generally follows a structure. Our function is broken into three sections consisting of, first, detoxification. This phase should be completed with the help of medical professionals due to the potential for serious uncomfortable withdrawal symptoms. And many times individuals are given medication to help alleviate the painful side effects of withdrawal. The second stage is rehabilitation, and there are two types, inpatient rehab and outpatient rehab. Inpatient rehab is an intensive treatment program that requires you to check into a facility for a certain period of time, usually 30, 60, or 90 days. Outpatient rehab allows individuals to participate in a recovery program while continuing with their daily life. Talk with your doctor about treatment options to determine which form of recovery will best fit your needs. The recovery process doesn't end with the completion of rehab. Long-term sobriety requires ongoing therapy and may entail support groups such as Alcoholics Anonymous, counseling, and other recovery resources. These will help maintain sobriety, but family support is also crucial. And can I add, the prayer does change things. Thank you.